So, hum pehle, we have discussed on the prevention in our earlier sessions. Dr. Arvind has shared some of his views on prevention. So, we are today we are talking more extensively on promotion. So, however, I have briefly brought here the differences between prevention and promotion aspects. Basically, there are certain concepts which may overlap. प्रिवेंशन में जो हम बात कर रहे हैं वो प्रमोशन में भी आ सकती है और लाइकवाइज वट एवर इज देयर इन द प्रमोशन द कॉन्सेप्ट्स मे बी यूज्ड इन द प्रिवेंटिव एस्पेक्ट्स आल्सो हाउएवर द एम्फेसिस इन मेंटल हेल्थ प्रमोशन इज ऑन पॉजिटिव मेंटल हेल्थ एंड प्रिवेंशन एम्फेसिस इज ऑन कॉजेस ऑफ द डिसीज सो प्रिवेंशन में हम कैसे डिसीज को प्रिवेंट करें और द पैथोलॉजिकल एक्सपीरियंसेस को हम कम करें वो हम प्रिवेंशन में सोचते हैं और प्रमोशन में वी मोस्टली टॉक अबाउट पॉजिटिव मेंटल हेल्थ सो आइडियल्स ऑफ हेल्थ प्रमोशन आर बेस्ड ऑन व्हाट कॉजेस गुड हेल्थ एंड व्हाट फैक्टर्स और डिटरमिनेंट्स आर लिंक्ड टू हेल्थ एंड विच ऑफ दीज आर मॉडिफाइएबल एंड हाउ दे आर मॉडिफाइएबल सो दीज आर द फ्यू क्वेश्चंस विच वी गेट आंसर इन प्रमोशन ऑफ मेंटल हेल्थ हमारे गुड हेल्थ के लिए हम क्या करना चाहिए और कौन सा फैक्टर्स एक गुड हेल्थ को मेंटेन करेंगे और प्रमोट करते हैं करता है और हम बेटर मेंटल हेल्थ के लिए या पॉजिटिव मेंटल हेल्थ के लिए कैसे हम मॉडिफाई करें एंड कैसे और क्यों और कैसे मॉडिफाई करें इस तरफ का कुछ सोच हमको प्रमोशन ऑफ मेंटल हेल्थ में मिलता है सो अगेन इट टॉक्स मोर अबाउट support for health and well being and not for the disease and it helps in understanding the competence of a person resources available in the community what are the strengths of the person or the community is taraf ka various factors are covered in positive mental health or in the process of promotion of mental health but in prevention hum kya discuss karte hain what are the specific disorders what are the chances of reducing the problems and hum kaise prevalence ko or seriousness ko kam kare aur ek targeted problems kya hai aur kaise hum isko eradicate karne ko try kare for example tuberculosis was an earlier very big epidemic so what we started is prevention of the disease so this is the kind of scenario we see in mental illness also so far how to reduce the illness severity so medication ko kaise stabilize kare aur mental illness how it we can avoid from somebody getting into mental illness so these are the few things which we discuss in prevention but promotion mein with maybe existing mental illness or without existing any mental illness still how do we sustain a mental health of an individual is what we see in promotion and so what we generally focus is on shift from illness to well being and for that maybe earlier intervention with groups at high risk early intervention with high risk group which are affected which may be affected by mental health so this is all promoting well being in the individual or community so any action aap अपना हॉस्पिटल में ले लीजिए या अपना कम्युनिटी में ले लीजिए एनी एक्शन विच एनहांसेस मेंटल वेलबींग ऑफ एन इंडिविजुअल और द फैमिलीज और द ऑर्गेनाइजेशंस और द कम्युनिटी कैन बी ए मेंटल हेल्थ प्रमोशन एंड सर्टेन फैक्टर्स पॉजिटिवली इट शुड इम्पैक्ट अस मे बी हाउ वी थिंक हाउ वी फील इंडिविजुअली और वेन वी आर इन ए ग्रुप so without impacting our mental health without impacting someone else's mental health how balancedly we manage ourselves is also promotion of mental health so because you are trying to create a positive environment around it helps in overall health and well being so in this way we are trying to promote mental health so here whether person has illness or not is secondary to us having an illness still there is a possibility for mental health promotion is what we discuss here okay so over a period of time actually now for the past 20 years the promotion of mental health is very seriously talked topic I think district mental health program and even before National Mental Health Program, NMHP also was talking briefly about promotion of mental health. So the interest has grown because of two reasons over a period of time. One is mental health is seen increasingly seen as fundamental to physical health and quality of life. So mental health theek hai to physical health theek rahega aur hamara quality of life bhi theek rahega. So isiliye to keep the mental health, good mental health and good physical health, we need to have something which promotes this overall health and well-being. So promotion got a very big boom or very big importance because physical health was associated with mental health and mental health was associated with physical health. So this is the time they started realizing that both have to be very well taken care. So disease to manage karne ke liye treatment hai, medicines hai, doctors hai, aur promotion ke liye bhi maybe people like social workers like us have to work. So that's why NMHP and now DMHP also has various programs and promotional activities for promotion of mental health. So if you see in children, it may be for better educational performance. If you see in adults working population, it may be greater productivity of workers. If you see couple it or the family environment, it may be to have an improved relationship within the families. And in larger perspective, it is to basically safeguard or have a safer community. So these are the first important reason why mental health promotion is taking very severe or very serious note. Second important thing is that there are appropriate care and treatment should be in place. So prevention ke liye or curative aspects ke liye humko treatment ka things are in place, but how do we make sure that this is reaching in right way or this is enjoyed or after the treatment, after the curative aspect, how the person is able to enjoy better quality of life? So ye sab ek question tha. So isko focus karne ke liye or to bring this kind of attitude in people in globally, nationally, local policy level and in our practice, this promotion of mental health taken a very big role. So you would see this diagram here. This diagram basically talks about various, four different directions or dimensions of an optimal health or optimal mental health. So in one side you have optimal mental health and the other side you have poor mental health. And in one side you have serious mental illness and on the other side you have no symptoms of mental illness. So we may have to promote or understand this diagram to understand how our community or how our people are, where exactly our people are now currently. So are there people with optimal mental health? No mental illness. So that means they have positive outlook towards life. They have better resilience. They have better coping skills. So these are the various aspects which will make us understand that, okay, this person or this family or this people in this community have optimal mental health and there is no mental illness. So that will generally be an ideal situation. So kabhi kabhi aisa bhi situations hai wherein optimal mental health with mental illness ke saath bhi kuch optimal mental health ko hum experience kar sakte hain. And because of severity of disorder, because of very much of disabled conditioning of the severity of mental illness, sometimes you have poor mental health with mental illness bhi hai aur isko manage karna, balance karna bhi nahi ho raha hai. So that is an extreme situation. So you may have people in the community with this kind of scenarios, but you also have on the better side, on the negative side, mental illness nahi hai fir bhi you have poor mental health. So this is another kind of scenario, another diagram I think I am having here which will give you better outlook. So a similar way like where you have optimal mental health and poor mental health, it is measured in a well-being scale. Like for example, good well-being and poor well-being. Then you have, I have no diagnosis of mental health, mental illness, and I am well and I am enjoying my life. So this is a complete optimal state. Then you have, I have no diagnosis, but I'm not coping and I'm not happy. These are the categories of people, they are more prone to mental illness. So this should be, this kind of people should be given more and adequate attention to promote mental health. So the first category is already enjoying the mental health. So we don't have to take good care of them, but we have to encourage them to remain there. Let them not have any breakdown. So they have to remain there. The second category is I have no diagnosis, but still I am not able to cope and I am not happy is very dangerous situation who may develop the mental illness at later stage. So you have one more category of people where I have mental health diagnosis, but I am not coping and I am not happy. And you also have a category where I have mental health problems, but I am coping well and enjoying my life. So do you call this as a promotion of mental health? I have mental illness, but I am coping well and I am enjoying my life. This is the category that we have to generally encourage and make sure that they remain there. So first two categories should be given importance. And the second two categories require your full attention. So this is something called mental health continuum. Where are we generally need to focus for our promotion of mental health? So these are the population to whom we have to work closely. Hope you are working. Aapka jo population hai, isme andar kaun sa koi bhi category mein hoga. So for all of them, your focus is to make sure that they follow this diagram. Okay. For example, early years, school, home and relationship areas, community, neighborhood, workplace, later life, elderly. So, and certain occupations where we feel safe and we are included, we are valued, we are respected. And sometimes challenging the stigma of mental health, that also becomes one of your important responsibility to promote mental health. Hum stigma ko deal nahi kar rahe aur kaun karega, isn't it? So we have to make sure that because of maintaining this equilibrium, I have, even if I have mental illness, still I have a better mental health to bring into that category, or I have no diagnosis and I have full mental health. To bring into these categories, you may have to work with these people. And so aap sabko pata hai, aap, not necessarily that all of you work in psychiatric setup only. Sometimes you may have other diagnoses also, which are related to epilepsy or which are related to other physical diagnosis associated with mental health problems. So in this category of, or in this group also, promotion of mental health is very, very important. So what it helps is basically improving mental health and lowering the personal and social cost of mental ill health. So this is the public health approach that we are trying to follow here. So always, whoever is working in other public health domains along with mental health, please make sure that mental health promotion is an integral part of health promotion, in be it in theory or be it in practice. So it is not necessarily only for people with mental illness. It can be any group, overall population with whom we are working. And sometimes it may be applicable to us also, because our mental health also should be in the same equilibrium like how I explained before. So in that context, we also need to be understanding that we are also part of the larger population. So sometimes we have to work with vulnerable groups or sometimes individuals at risk, and people with mental health problems, of course, will be our goal, our population. So how do we promote that? Maybe one is at individual level. You work with the individual, you help to promote the mental health. You work with the community, and there also you try to promote the mental health. Then there are certain barriers, maybe in your workplace. During last session, not this batch, previous batch, some of the staff were telling that they want to help promoting mental health by various activities, they wanted to provide, disability certificate to some people. They wanted to conduct certain groups, but they did not have support from the treating team. That means the other team members. So sometimes what happens, this can be a barrier for not promoting the mental health. So I am requesting you all, if such restrictions are there or barriers are there, first try to eradicate that so that you can reach to more people in the community. So reducing the structural barriers to mental health is also an important aspect of mental health promotion. So as I said, individual level, community level, and reducing the structural barriers. So in the concept, there are various other small concepts in the promotion of mental health. One is positive mental health, which for your therapy or for your intervention or for your counseling, you can use these concepts, how you want to promote mental health. One possibility is that you make the individual understand his or her potential, maximum realization of one's potential. So, which helps them to exploit their potential so that they do not have a breakdown. So, they are in the optimal level. Second concept is sense of mastery. So, they are the best judge of their problems. They know how to deal with that. They know how to cope with that. They know how to achieve a sense of mastery through working towards the problem. Not running away, not blaming, not putting blame on others. So these, instead of doing these kind of negative aspects, let them have a sense of mastery over environment. They know how to deal with the problem. So they have a better mental health. Another concept is called autonomy, wherein individual having the ability to identify, confront, or solve problems. Not that all the time we don't face problems. We will face problems. Clients will face problems. But it does not mean that they have to just succumb to the problem. But they can identify the problem, they can confront, and they can try to solve the problems. So, and you have another concept called resilience. How to handle the stresses which are tremendously affecting the individuals. You have another concept called life skills. So through your developmental phases, you can use the life skills. You also know that WHO is also promoting life skills. So this is also another important concept for mental health promotion. So this is briefly about mental health promotion.